You may have some questions about coronary artery disease. In terms of understanding the process, coronary artery disease is related to atherosclerosis of the coronary arteries, which simply means that arteries that supply blood to the heart become blocked due to fatty deposits calcification, etc., etc. It's a very common problem of Western civilization. Things that contribute to coronary artery disease include high blood pressure, diabetes, hyperlipidemia, smoking, and in particular, genetic predisposition. You can have a perfectly healthy lifestyle, but still have coronary artery disease because it tends to run in your family. So this is important to recognize. For the surgical side of things, coronary artery surgery is really the most well-studied operation in the history of surgery. We know what causes coronary artery disease. We know what the outcomes of coronary artery surgery are, what the complications are, and especially we know what the benefits are. We perform bypasses to the blockages in the coronary arteries. What that does is allow blood flow, oxygen, and nutrients to get to the muscle beyond where the blockages are. That relieves the chest pain, it keeps you from going to the hospital, it decreases the chance of having further heart attacks, and overall, based on the studies that have been done for years and years in populations who have had coronary artery bypass surgery, we know that it increases your lifespan. Most of our patients stay in the hospital for 4 to 7 days, depending on how quickly you recover from the surgery. Coronary artery disease often develops slowly, so patients adjust their activities based on what they feel like they can do. Oftentimes we'll hear a patient say, well, yes, I don't do this anymore because, well, I'm getting older. But it turns out that it's not age that was a factor, it was the coronary artery disease. So once we revascularize the heart, they can return to these activities in a vibrant, extraordinary fashion that they hadn't realized, and they can do things that they haven't done for years. In terms of facing the reality of an open heart surgery, the confidence and the trust that is between the patient and the surgeon is paramount. And if both of us believe that we're going to do well, that we're going to have an outstanding outcome, and that everything's going to be all right, well, that's 90% of any operation. The technical aspect's the smallest part. Patients are fully recovered within a month or so after the open heart surgery. However, we continue to follow our patients for years in the future. And of course, when and if, wherever needed, for questions, concerns, or additional problems, we're happy to see our patients at any time.